I recently, just last week, returned from my eighth tour of Falling Water, and I came back with lots of new insights, and I wanted to share them in a series of short video clips. So in this clip, I'm just going to focus on one thing, and that is an insight that I gained regarding how Frank Lloyd Wright designed the entranceways or the approaches to the entrance doorway to his structures. And I actually have two insights about this. So I'm going to provide one insight in this video, and then I'm going to do a separate video on the other insight. But what I want to do, what I want to do is avoid the cliched, stereotypical discussion, which is the whole idea of compress and release or confine and release. So it's just a cliche that all people talk about when they talk about his approaches to entryways, is this idea of compress and release. So they'll say Wright wanted to compress you into a small, tight space that almost felt uncomfortable, and then release you into the larger space of the interior of the structure. And this is true. I mean, it's correct. It's accurate. That's one thing that he was doing, but that's all people talk about. And he was doing a lot more than just that. So I'd like to share one of those things right now. And that is what Wright was doing as he approached the entryways to some of his buildings is creating a transitional space. So what he wanted to do is give you a gradual transition from being in the state of being totally outdoors to the state of being totally indoors. Okay. He didn't want that transition to be abrupt like it did if you just approached a building and walked through the door. He wanted to make it very gradual. So what he's doing is you can think of this the approach or the approach to the entrance in four stages. So the stage one is you're totally outdoors, stage four is you're totally indoors. And between the two, he's putting you down a sort of an indoor-outdoor hallway, okay? For the first half of that indoor-outdoor hallway, the balance is tipped toward feeling like you're outdoors. So it's sort of like an outdoor hallway, and you feel more like you're outdoors than indoors, okay? At a certain point, you'll cross a threshold, and you'll start to feel, he sort of reverses that balance. You feel like more like you're indoors and fully confined versus outdoors. And then you get to the door and you cross into the house and you're fully inside the house, right? So here at Falling, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how he approached it in Falling Water and then give you another example from another building. But in Falling Water, this is the hallway, the indoor outdoor hallway. This is the beginning of it. And you can see what Wright is going to do. I'll show you with this video. What he's going to do is start off by first, he's going to introduce this wall. So that's the beginning of the hallway. It doesn't have an opposed wall yet, right? So you start to walk down this wall. After you've walked a little ways past the wall, he's going to give you this partial roof. And I forget the name of this device, but it's like bands of steel with space between them, almost like a trellis, right? So you've got one wall, partial roof. And then you get to the point where he introduces the opposed wall to create the full indoor outdoor hallway. And that's when the roof becomes solid. Okay. And let me show you here. This is a series of photographs. So here you can see you walk a little bit down this past this wall, and this semi roof starts. That's sort of like, open, partially open. And then you get to this opposed wall, and then you can see the roof become solid. Now, you're still going to feel like you're indoors and outdoors here. And this is actually a break in the wall, which you'll see. So it's you have a short wall here, and then it opens to the outdoors again. So you're still feeling like you're outside. Here you can see the break here. There's like a pool of water here with a fountain dropping water in there. And then it opens to the left too. And there's another photograph after this one. You can see it better. Yeah. So you can see when you get to this point, the wall breaks on each side. You could go left, you could go out to a patio or walk on to the left a little bit and then go up these stairs. To the right, you're going to see there's a little pool here, and you provide some continuity with a small curb here, which kind of provides continuation, but also blocks you. It contains the pool of water here. But then you're going to get to this point where you can see the roof is going to drop, right? And you're going to have solid wall on each side. That's when you make that transition to this indoor-outdoor hallway, where it becomes more indoors than outdoors because it's fully confined. And you'll see as this continues. That's the break. You can see he has the pool here. So what he's doing here is creating a barrier, right? So you can't walk through here. So in a way, he wants you to feel like you're still contained, but he's giving you access, visual, spatial access to the outdoors, but you're not going to cross this threshold. It's still a barrier, which is like a continuation of the wall. So it's still confining you inside this indoor-outdoor hallway. Now we're at the next phase. You can see the walls get more narrow, the ceiling drops a bit, and you've got the door here. So you're going to go through this. You're still outdoors, but you feel like the balance has tipped to being more indoors because the space is totally confined. Now you're indoors. And what you can't see this, but if you were standing here looking at this desk, if you pivoted to your left, there'd be like two or three steps to your left that come up to like your mid thigh or so. And you step up those steps, and then you're in the living room. So, and I always feel when I get to this point like I'm in a ship, like I'm up above deck, and I'm about to, enter the steps to go below deck where things open up. It just gives me this feeling every time. But you get the idea. Now I said I want to give you another example. Oh, I want to credit this video. This was How to Have Fun Outdoors, and they just posted this a few days ago. But I have a second example for you. And this is from Hollyhock House. Hollyhock House is one of the five concrete block, textile block houses that Wright designed and built in the 1920s out in California, like around LA. And so this was a decade before Falling Water, and he was using this approach back then, and he did this in Hollyhock House. So this is a Bob Vila tour that Bob did. So you can see that it's the same layout. It's these four stages. So beyond this, you can see this is the threshold where the indoor-outdoor hallway starts. Beyond that, stage one, you're outdoors. You step across the threshold, you're in this indoor-outdoor hallway. And for the first half where they are, it's balanced more toward feeling like you're outdoors. So you got, just like at Falling Water, you get the big break here. You got like these windows here. You got windows in the side, this side that are bigger but have these slats on them. So you really feel like you're outdoors. They're going to cross a threshold, and then the hallway's going to continue, but it's going to be totally closed off. And then they'll get to the doorway, and they'll cross the doorway. So you'll see that. There's another break, and then they hit this threshold. Now they're in this confined area, totally confined. And you can see Wright has a, I think this is a skylight or a light. I think it's a skylight. And then they cross the threshold of the door, and they're inside. So again, I want to be clear. I'm not saying that Wright did not compress and release in these structures. He obviously did. We can see that. But there's a lot more to what he was doing. It was multidimensional. He was very complex. And in the other video I'm going to share a different insight about one of the psychological effects the second psychological effect I think you wanted to have in doing this. So the first effect was this idea of, you know, sort of this gradual transition from outdoors to indoors, right? So you didn't have just this abrupt change when you go from like being outdoors to stepping across the door and you're indoors, right? But I'll share the second insight in the other video that I do.